Glacial erosion carves out a variety of landforms. Even in regions where there are no glaciers, many landforms are evidence that they once existed there. The South Island off New Zealand has hundreds of fjords, ribbon lakes, and U-shaped valleys that exist as reminders of the giant glaciers that once were there. A Corrie, also known as a Cirque, is an erosion feature formed at the starting point of a glacier. Corries have a rounded hollow with a steep back wall. Corries form when snow accumulates in hollows on mountainsides, slowly accumulating enough to turn into ice. This ice slowly gouges out a steep back wall through the processes of freeze-thaw and plucking. Large crevasses on the top of the ice, called a bergschrund, allows water to flow onto the ice where it freezes to create more ice. The bottom of the Corrie is eroded by abrasion as the ice moves in a circular motion known as rotational slip. At the front of the ice, the erosion is less, causing a lip of rock to be left there. As more ice accumulates, it flows over the lip and into the valley below, forming a glacier. In places where glaciers have retreated, the Corrie was often filled by meltwater to form a lake. The rock lip and moraine act as a natural dam. These lakes are known as tarns. When two Corries form back to back, they both erode backwards until they create a narrow knife edge ridge between them. These sharp ridges are called anaretes. Sometimes, three Corries back into each other. They eventually erode backwards to leave a sharp pyramid peak. An example of this is Mount Aspiring in the Southern Alps of New Zealand. Glaciers carve out U-shaped valleys, just as a river produces a V-shaped valley. Usually, a glacier will follow the general direction of a river valley, but instead of flowing around areas of hard rock like a river does, a glacier will cut straight through it. This means that when the glacier melts, it leaves behind a U-shaped valley with very steep sides. There are numerous U-shaped valleys in the South Island off New Zealand. The warmer North Island only has small glaciers on the summit of Mount Ruapehu. For example, the Whakapapa Glacier, seen here. However, at Mount Tongariro, you can see the evidence that larger glaciers once existed here in the form of the U-shaped Mangatopopo Valley. Some glaciers, such as the Fox and Franz Josef Glacier, descend to low altitudes not far from the Tasman Sea. When global temperatures and accompanying sea levels rise, low-lying U-shaped valleys get filled with water to become a fjord. This produces a coastline with an irregular shape, like those also found in Norway, Western Canada, and Fiordland New Zealand. Another feature associated with valley glaciers are hanging valleys. The floors of the tributary valleys are eroded at a slower rate than the floor of the main valley, so the difference between the depths of two valleys steadily increases over time. The tributaries are left hanging high above the main valley, with their rivers and streams entering the main valley by means of either a large waterfall or a series of smaller waterfalls. The valley sides may also have truncated spurs, which are the ends of sloping ridges that have been cut off or truncated by the valley glacier, which flows straighter than a river would. You can see these features in this diagram. Finally, retreating glaciers leave behind ribbon lakes on the valley floor, with the terminal moraine acting to form a dam to hold the water in. These are also known as finger lakes because they are long and narrow. The South Island has numerous lakes that fill deep valleys excavated with glaciers. For example, the 42-kilometre Lake Wanaka, which lies in an ancient U-shaped valley. The ancient terminal moraine encircles the lower end of the lake. A smaller example of a ribbon lake is Lake Alexandrina in the Mackenzie Basin. This lake has been enclosed behind moraines left behind by an ancient glacial advance.